How annoyed would you be if you were sitting on a plane and watched another airplane whiz past you? What if that other plane had left from the same airport and was going to the same destination as you were? This happens all the time. How do you make sure you are on the fast flight? Watch this video because we're about to tell you. In busy airports, there are always multiple flights headed to the same destination. These flights are likely using the same type of plane and might even be leaving at the same time. But if you look at when they arrive at their destination, the times can be wildly different. Most people want to spend as little time as possible on the plane. So how do you decide which airline to go with to make sure you are on the fastest flight? The first thing to consider is the company and its goal. For example, some airlines were designed to be budget-friendly, like Spirit and Southwest. There's nothing wrong with passengers saving money as long as you know what you're getting yourself into. Budget-friendly airlines tend to charge extra fees for things that come standard on other flights. This includes checked bags or being able to choose a seat. These airlines may also add extra rows to their aircraft, resulting in less legroom, so they can fit more passengers aboard. This is when flight times between the airlines begin to vary. In order to keep costs down, companies need to be as efficient as possible. This includes how much fuel they use and how quickly they burn through it. Think of an airplane like a very fast car. Like all automobiles, there's a sweet spot for plane engines where they'll be the most fuel efficient. If you're driving 85 miles per hour down a highway, your gas mileage will be a lot lower than if you were driving 55 miles per hour. This is because most car engines get their best gas mileage between 50 and 65 miles per hour. The question is, what is the best speed for a plane engine to run in order to save the airline money? On average, it's between 400 and 600 miles per hour for a commercial airliner. However, there are several factors that will determine the precise speed at which the plane engines are most fuel efficient. Sometimes this is a slower speed than other airlines, which can result in different flight times. Most airlines try to keep their planes flying at these optimum speeds to increase fuel efficiency and decrease cost. Once a plane reaches a cruising altitude, the airline will mandate certain speeds to make sure that the plane is using as little fuel as possible. However, in some situations, a shorter flight time might be more important than fuel economy. On average, a budget-friendly company will fly its planes at a slower speed to save on fuel so they can maintain their cheap prices. If you're planning a trip and you see multiple flights leaving at the same time for the same destination, keep this in mind. The amount of time it will actually take to land will be dependent on the airline company and their policies. There's another caveat to this, though. Airline companies may break their own fuel efficiency rules under certain circumstances. If it's determined that it's more profitable to have flights arrive at the next airport quicker so they can fly more flights per day, then plane speeds will increase. If an airline can have multiple fully booked flights right after the other, then getting to the next destination faster at the expense of fuel efficiency may be worth it. This only works if the company can make sure that their flights are as full as possible. It does not help an airline to fly faster to cram in empty flights. When booking your next airline trip, it might be worth taking into consideration the number of flights each airline has per day. The more flights the airline has booked for the day, the quicker they'll try to get from destination to destination. This could end up shortening your flight time as the planes may be directed to fly faster. Then again, there are certain airlines that will break all of these rules to try to make your flying experience as quick and enjoyable as possible. Which airlines do this, you might be wondering? The very expensive ones. Some airlines don't worry as much about fuel costs or how many flights they can get in per day because their whole business model is based around luxury. And with anything that is high-end and geared toward the wealthy, these flights are really expensive. We're talking about airlines like Etihad Airways, Virgin Atlantic, and Swiss International Airlines. Unless you're specifically searching for flights on those airlines, they normally won't appear on a budget-friendly search engine like Kayak or Skyscanner. This is because there is nothing budget-friendly about them. But if you want to be pampered on a plane flying faster than the others, these types of airlines get the job done. For a steep price, that is. For the rest of us ordinary people, there are some other tricks airlines use to decrease flight times. Some airlines will have their planes fly at lower altitudes. This allows them to fly a little faster. The trade-off is there's greater chance of running into turbulent weather. Flying at a lower altitude is done more easily when the plane is lighter, which brings us to another reason that different flights going to the same destination may be flying at different speeds. It all has to do with weight. The lighter an aircraft is, the faster it can fly while maintaining fuel efficiency. If you're on a flight with less passengers, the plane may be able to make it to its destination faster. This is because a lighter aircraft can use less fuel even if it's flying faster than a full, heavy plane flying at a slower speed. With less passengers, there's less luggage, and with less of both these things, the plane is lighter. That means that if you're trying to get to your destination as fast as possible, a less packed flight may be the way to go. Weight plays another important role in the duration of flight length. Heavier planes will take longer to climb to their cruising altitude and top speed. This means that these flight times are extended compared to a light plane that can reach its optimum speed quicker. You may not think about it as you're flying through the air, but the weight of the plane you're on is actually changing over the course of the flight. During a long journey, a plane will carry out a maneuver called a step climb. This is when a plane changes altitude several times over the course of a flight to allow for faster speeds and more efficiency. The reason this happens is that as the plane burns fuel, it becomes lighter. An airplane is always heavier at takeoff than when it lands. Since the weight of the aircraft changes during the flight, it means that the pilot needs to adjust altitude and speed to compensate. If done correctly, the plane can increase its speed while maintaining fuel efficiency. In the age of computers, this is being calculated by navigation systems, allowing flights to keep their fuel economy at optimum levels. Although it is incredibly rare, some low-budget airlines might use planes where pilots themselves need to calculate when to carry out the step climb, which leaves room for human error and slower speeds. Your best chance of catching a fast flight is by booking a partially filled plane on an airline that flies a lot of routes. That being said, there are always factors beyond your and the airline's control that will affect flight speeds. Weather plays a big role in the length of flights. Sometimes planes need to be rerouted around developing storms. Other times, flights may need to increase their altitude or decrease their speed due to weather conditions. In these circumstances, there isn't much you as a passenger can do. Once you've made an informed decision about the flight you've booked and you're in the air, everything else is out of your control. It's also worth remembering that flight times to and from the same destination will almost always be different. This is true regardless of the airline you're flying with. For example, if you're flying from Seattle, Washington to New York City, your flight time will be considerably shorter than someone who's flying the reverse route at the same time. This is because of the way the wind currents move across our planet. Due to the Earth's rotation and a variety of other factors, wind currents move from the Pacific Ocean across the continental US and toward the Atlantic. This means that during the flight from Seattle to New York City, the wind currents are literally pushing the plane along, allowing it to travel faster on less fuel. When traveling the route from east to west, the plane is fighting against the winds, which creates drag and slows the plane down. More often than not, when you fly somewhere, you need to return back to where you started. Unfortunately, this means one of your flights will most likely be longer than the other, even if you're following the same route. And if you really want to find the fastest way to travel via commercial airlines, you need to travel back in time, because the planes of today are nowhere near as fast as what used to be flying the skyways. Not too long ago, you could catch a flight from the US to Europe in under 3 hours. Today, the fastest commercial planes can barely make the journey in 6 hours. This is because planes like the Concorde used jet engines that could break the sound barrier and reach speeds of up to Mach 2.04, which is about 1,350 miles per hour. Today, there are no commercial flights through major airline companies that come close to these speeds. This is mostly for safety reasons, but also because it's extremely expensive to fly that fast. Even though the planes of today could surpass 600 miles per hour if they needed to, things get pretty dangerous as a plane approaches the speed of sound. The turbulence at those speeds could literally tear the airplane apart, which would end up tragically cutting your journey short. If you're looking for a ride on the fastest plane in service today, you need to book a flight on a 747-8 Intercontinental. These planes can cruise at speeds of 660 miles per hour, which is approximately Mach 0.86. This is a long way from reaching the speeds of past supersonic jets, but it is the fastest commercial airliner that's flying today. And since the demand for faster planes isn't really prevalent, airline companies have no incentive to invest in expensive new technology that would shorten flight times. They don't even need to push their current planes to go faster, because the average consumer does not complain about flight lengths. Therefore, the airplane companies don't usually compete with one another to shorten their flight times by flying faster. So, other than airline goals, weight, technology, and weather, it is the collective decision of all the passengers to not demand uniform faster flights. These factors are what causes airlines to fly their planes at different speeds to maximize profits. Now watch what happens when a bird hits a plane engine. Or check out, did Pan Am Flight 914 really land 37 years later?